On behalf of the veterans of Foreign Wars Post 52, we would like to thank St. Luke's Church and School for allowing us to be here to be a part of your flag retirement. So what we're going to do this morning is we're going to take the old flag down. We will fold that flag. We will present it to your principal. We will then ask Annie to give us the new flag. We will put the new flag up.
Come on, guard! Hit! Ha! Part! Harm! Freeze it! Harm! Color guard, hit, ha! Heart, harm! Freeze and harm!
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight? Stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. O'er the rampart we watched where so gallantly streamed in the rocket's red glare, the bomb bursting in air gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
I pledge allegiance to the
flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one
Mark time! Mark! Detail! Halt! Right! Pace! Order! Hounds!
Once again, juniors and students, parents, guests, thank you once again for allowing VFW Veterans of Foreign Wars Post 52 to be here today to retire your school flag as we just did, but also to educate you about the flag that we have. The United States flag, the American flag, and this morning we'll talk about the Vets and Cross flag. Thank you to Principal John Reisner and your student council representative, and thank you very much. We appreciate your help out there. On my left is the California state flag. It was designed in 1846 and officially adopted by the state of California in 1911. California was the 31st state to be accepted into the Union. Therefore, the 31st star on the American flag signifies the state of California. In the early 1800s, grizzly bears were very common in the land we now call California. Eventually, the grizzly bear became the official state animal. The bear on the California flag portrays strength. The star on the flag represents sovereignty. The color red represents courage. The white background on the California flag stands for purity. On my right is the Betsy Ross flag. It was a very early design of the American flag, and some historians say that General George Washington, before he became our first president of the United States, asked Betsy Ross to sew a flag from the design that he had in his pocket, and that flag would be for the American people. In 1777, the Stars and Stripes, as the flag would be known, became the official national flag. Betsy Ross is known as a patriotic role model for young girls and as a symbol of women's contributions to our American history. We pledge the allegiance outside. It's a simple promise. We're giving our word that we will be loyal to our country. That's what the flag stands for. We decide who our leaders are in America. We have elections. We are the people. We are free, and we should treat other people fairly and free also. The American flag has been the symbol of our nation's strength and unity. It's been a source of pride and inspiration for millions of citizens. The American flag stands for our whole country, and that is the way that we tell the rest of the world that we stand together as one. It also shows that we are connected to each other as Americans. Because our flag is special, we are all very special. And we treat everybody with respect. Some Americans have jobs to protect and help us. Those people are like police officers, firemen, crossing guards, school teachers, and even park rangers. Others, like the men and women in our Army and Navy, they also help and protect us, and they are many, many miles away from us. No matter where these people are, they are here to keep us safe. 237 years ago, our first official flag was born when our country was new. The flag is made of 13 red and white stripes, representing each of the 13 original states. The white stars placed on a blue field also represent each state. The flag consists of three colors, red, white, and blue. Red was for the bravery of our soldiers who made the sacrifice for us and others to be free. White was for purity. It's not our country that's pure, but the people inside us, you and I. We as a nation believe in ourselves and are always willing to lend a hand to help others in need. Blue represents the sky. It reminds us to set our goals high. As you've been told in your classroom, anything is possible. In July of 1969, the American flag was flown in space with Neil Armstrong. He planted a flag on the moon's surface. There are currently six U.S. flags planted on the surface of the moon. I'm proud to be an American, and always will be. I am especially grateful for all the freedoms we have in the United States. Never forget how lucky we are to be living in the United States of America. And we should show respect to our flags and the country we live in. When you see the American flag, remember to believe in yourself, be a good citizen, and follow the law. The first fold stands for liberty. In America, we are free to own property, to elect our government representatives, to attend the church of our choice, to openly disagree, to travel freely without restriction, to pursue an education, and pursue the American dream. The white stripes of the flag symbolize our liberty. The second fold represents unity. Abraham Lincoln stated that a house divided against itself cannot stand. Natural disasters and extreme external threats bring our nation together, such as those on September 11, 2001. The third fold stands for justice. In America, we believe that every person stands for equal before the law and is deserving of just and fair treatment. The blue of the flag embodies justice. The fourth fold symbolizes perseverance. To persevere means to endure, to remain steadfast, despite severe hardships and obstacles. The Continental Army suffered repeated setbacks before claiming any significant victory. Yet throughout the brutal war of 1777 and Valley Forge, they persevered. The fifth fold represents hardiness. Hardiness is the ability to withstand difficulty while remaining resolute despite adversity. The aggressors in World War II underestimated the American hardiness. They thought that Americans were soft, incapable, and unwilling to endure hardship. Our soldiers and sailors, such as those that fought in Normandy and Korea, proved them wrong. The sixth fold stands for valor. Valor means courage, the act of defending what is right, even in the face of opposition. Nathan Hale, a Revolutionary War patriot, was convicted of spying by the British in 1776. Before he was hanged, Hale displayed great valor with his words, "I only regret that I have but one life to live for my country." The red color of the flag represents valor, symbolic of the bloodshed by all American heroes who sacrificed for our freedom. The seventh fold symbolizes purity. A pure nation is free from taint, from what weakens, pollutes, or renders it ineffective. Our founding fathers illuminated freedom's path for us when we created the Declaration of Independence, the Constitution, and the Bill of Rights. The pure intent of these documents enabled the United States of America to become the greatest nation of all, a land of liberty which beckons to all those seeking asylum from persecution and oppression. The eighth fold represents innocence. Innocence implies that one is unacquainted with evil and thus free from sin. George Washington once stated, "The love of my country will be the ruling influence of my conduct." Americans pay tribute to him and to all those who give devoted service to uphold freedom's ideals without selfish or evil motivation. The ninth fold signifies sacrifice. Sacrifice is to give up something.
die-for ideal, belief, or goal. America exists today because of the sacrifices of countless Americans. Many have made the ultimate sacrifice of their lives in battles waged during the Revolution, the World Wars, Korea, Vietnam, Gulf War, Afghanistan, and other locations around the world. We pay tribute to them and to the firefighters and the policemen, members of our armed forces, and numerous others who continue to sacrifice for our freedom. The tenfold stands for honor. One who possesses honor possesses a keen sense of ethical conduct. To honor a person or ideal is to display respect to them. We give thanks for all who have acted with honor in founding and growth of America. We pray that each citizen of all those who represent us in government will conduct themselves in a manner that will continue to bring honor to our nation and to our flag. The 11th fold symbolizes independence. Independence is the state of being free, of being able to make unrestricted choices within the law, as free individuals and as a free nation. Ever since our nation's birth, Americans have fiercely defended their independence against all oppressors. Patrick Henry articulated the sentiments of his fellow Americans, past, present, and future, when he uttered those famous words, "Give me liberty, or give me death." America stands as an icon of freedom and independence for the oppressed of the world. May it always remain so. The 12th fold represents truth. Truth is the body of real events and facts. It is preserved through adherence to reality and the avoidance of falsehoods. America was built upon God-given truth, articulated in the Declaration of Independence, that all men are created equal, that they are endowed by their Creator with certain unalienable rights, that among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Adherence to these truths has made America a great nation. We pledge to continue this noble legacy of truth so that America, every man, woman, and child, may forever be free. Students, please stand. Students,
or
teachers,
help!
Some of you have loved ones, some
staff,
of you have
graphics.
Fathers who are veterans. Students, we have many heroes in this room. Six of them are behind me. These gentlemen are veterans of foreign wars. These gentlemen have fought for us. We thank them for their service.
One of our follow-up meet and greet the children. Yes.
Thank you.
Remember to say thank you.
There you are.
Thank you.
You're welcome. There you are. You're welcome. There you go.
My name is Bob. What is your name?
Savannah.
Savannah, it's nice to meet you. My name is Bob. What is your name?
Adrian.
Adrian, it's nice to meet you. Coming out.
Glad to meet you.
Your name is?
Thanks.
Vince, it's a pleasure to meet you. Thank you for coming out. My name is Bob.
Any of you have relatives in the military?
I have my grandpa.
What service is he in?
Vietnam.
Okay.
My dad is in the Air Force once.
My daughter is in the Navy.